Roy phone call. The Mysterious first found out about
Hello.
The family drama.
Good morning. Happy Thursday. Show day. Yay.
Red Table Talk is
real talk.
Real.
Family.
Community.
I'm just like, what were you thinking?
Chloe later turned to some serious anger, saying,
Hi.
When some fans were to Jordan and some were to Chloe, it's safe to say that nobody was interested. Season 15, Kim frees Alice Johnson. Kim's humanitarian side shone through in season 15, and the show followed the storyline of the budding law student working hard to free an innocent woman from prison. An emotional episode shows Kim. Alice Johnson, a wrongfully convicted grandmother who had spent over 20 years in prison for a crime she didn't commit. Kim worked with lawyers and even spoke to the former president to help Alice free. A phone call between the Skims creator and Miss Johnson had us in tears, and Kim lets her know she will finally be going home.
Oh my gosh, Alice, you're out.
Yeah. Now, Kim has decided to continue her lessons and is studying to become a full-fledged lawyer. All we have to say is that if we were stuck in hot water, we wouldn't mind having Kim K on our side.
Everyone else is living their life out of jail.
Season 14, Chloe's positive pregnancy test. In what was truly the best part of season 14, Chloe reveals on camera that she's expecting.
I'm pregnant.
After seeing Kim and Courtney cried as mothers, Chloe joined the mom gang. She took a pregnancy test that came out positive. Chloe was glowing as she shared the news.
We're nervous, but really excited. There's a million different emotions that are going on in my brain.
Now that all of the sisters, except top model Kendall, have kids, the pregnancy announcements aren't quite as exciting. Although, they're always...
Oh, my son.
Chloe is true.
Oh, you didn't know my son is sick? Like, they're saying he threw up at school?
We're sure Chloe will let us...
But right now, he's fine. He's just, you know, sometimes you just need to throw up.
Check
it out.
The second episode of Keeping Up with the Kardashians season 13 documents the moments leading up to the infamous Paris robbery and Kim's emotional journey afterward. While visiting the historic European city with her now ex-husband, Kanye West, for fashion
week, he's fine.
Men broke into Kim's hotel room to rob her jewelry in the middle of the night. The robbers used a weapon to hold Kim as they stole the family's valuables. They made off with a bag filled with over 12 pieces of jewelry and accessories, worth around 5.6 million.
Yeah, he had 5 times. The police later revealed that Kim was in tears,
trying to tell the thieves that she had children, begging them to spare her life. Kim was so shaken from the traumatic event that it took her weeks to recover. The star stayed out of the spotlight for a while after the scary night. Season 12, Rob's shocking news. The brother of the family tends to keep somewhat out of the spotlight these days.
My child had been crazy the whole time.
Rob was a big part of the reality show. Rob Kardashian was nervous to tell his sisters about his engagement to model Blac Chyna. Of course, they were happy for him, but he had one more piece of news to share. The intuitive Kardashian sisters yesed before he could spit it out.
Yeah.
Rob kept the tension high when he explained that he was getting married and having a baby. The family was more upset that he had kept his plans from them. These siblings are used to making decisions as a family. Season 11, Scott's scary phone call. Scott Disick may have only married into the Kardashian group when he got hitched to Kourtney Kardashian, but he's been one of the characters to bring the most drama and emotional moments to the show. In a season 11 episode, Kim had a text from Scott that prompted her to worry about her brother-in-law. She let Kourtney listen in on the conversation, which Scott sounded extremely upset. "I just want it over," Kim heard Scott say. The father of three was clearly feeling very down. Afterward, Scott had a stay in a rehab to help with his mental health. Season 10, Caitlyn Jenner is born. Caitlyn Jenner's transition was easily one of the most intense moments from Keeping Up with the Kardashians history. The entire family had to get on board with Caitlyn's decision to live as her authentic self, and it wasn't easy for everyone. When Chris first met her ex-husband in her new body, she was clearly filled with emotion. Chris and Caitlyn had a pleasant conversation, but it was evident to viewers that the room was filled with an Olympic-sized ball. Luckily for Kim, his knack for dramatic performance extended to his proposal to the reality star. Kanye popped the question in season 9 episode when he rented out an entire baseball stadium and filled it with music, flowers, fireworks, and, well, everything. Kanye even had Kim's family waiting in the stands until she said yes, so they could run out and surprise the new fiancés. Kim was in tears as Kanye got down on one knee and asked her to be his wife. The pair may have recently called it quits, but we still love watching this heartwarming episode and the beginning of their power couple era. Season 8, Kim's pregnancy reveal. The family show had already earned them massive fame by the 8th season, which meant their personal lives were thrown into the spotlight. Kim, in particular, couldn't go anywhere without being photographed by the media, which made her first pregnancy even more difficult. Revealing her drama-filled pregnancy to her family and Kanye was one of the biggest storylines of the season. The new mom became emotional on the show when she opened up about dealing with unflattering photos and tabloid rumors concerning her body. The show also documented Kim's emergency labor with Doris after she was rushed to the hospital. Season 7. Rob's weight loss journey. During the season of the reality show, Rob Kardashian was going through a tough time. The cameras caught his struggle with weight gain and mental health. Kris revealed that she believes her son gets tattoos to compensate for feeling down about himself, and a trip to the doctor told that he wished to remove the ink and stretch marks from his body. Rob felt like he was overweight and decided to try to shed a few pounds. In an emotional moment for the sock designer, Rob broke down crying about his weight and negative body image. Kris was there for him. "I'm not going to sit by and watch him give up," the momager said.
"Listen, I don't want to see some..."
Let me tell you. Hold on. Okay. This is a TV show. We actually got her tap my phone.
"Something horrible happened to you."
Season 6. Kim's psoriasis diagnosis. Kim has dealt with a lot over the 20 seasons of the show. One of the most challenging moments for the star was when she was diagnosed with psoriasis. The show captured a trip to Dr. Lancer, Kim's dermatologist. The doctor diagnosed Kim's red, flaky skin rashes as the incurable psoriasis condition, prompting Kim to worry about her health. When Kim learned that to control her illness, she'd have to slow down the pace of her lifestyle, some intense emotions ensued. Kim explained that it's crucial to be flawless in her line of work, and became emotional when she learned that with stress, the rashes could spread to her face.
"Because I have like psoriasis all over my face, so it is a challenge. We've never had that before."
Season 5. Kylie is forbidden to date. In a hilarious and hormone-filled episode, 13-year-old Kylie's dad forbids her to date or hang out with boys. When Kylie invites some friends over to the house, teen feelings run wild, and her dad puts his foot down. When Kylie innocently lets a boy come into her room so they can call to order pizza, her strict parent is having none of it. Guess what happens? If you've ever been a teenager, you can probably guess that the answer is lots of yelling.
"You broke the rules. I want the boys out
here." "You broke the rules?"
Okay, now we know why the star switched to homeschooling a few years later.
"Kylie, what?
What happened?"
Season 4, Khloé and Lamar's wedding. One of our absolute favorite moments of the show, Khloé and Lamar tied the knot in a very romantic episode of Season 4. The 2009 wedding was a surprise for fans, since Khloé and the NBA player hadn't been dating for very long. Viewers loved the on-screen romance, and Khloé and Lamar got their own spin-off series less than a year later. Recently, Lamar shared that when he watches old episodes of his and Khloé's relationship, he gets emotional. In a touching social media post, the star also thanked his ex-wife's family for their generous love and support. He wrote, "Y'all gave me family, and for that I am forever grateful." Season 3, Courtney feels left out. In earlier seasons, fans started seeing the divides caused between the Kardashian sisters on the need for their mom's attention and professional management. The Kardashians have always found a way to mix family and business, but in this heated episode, Courtney felt left out and neglected when Kris chose to help with Kim's photo shoot rather than hers.
"And this is when I really need her."
Courtney and Kim talked it out on a phone call and expressed how Kris can't always manage all of the siblings' projects. Of course, this led to Kris feeling like the girls were ganging up on her.
"I'm not.
You're selling me down the river.
I told you.
I heard exactly what you just said to her. That's not cool either."
the cameras were rolling. On the other hand, Kylie seemed pleased to help and even led a demonstration with the tool. It may have been embarrassing, but having older sisters teach you about life is what helped Kendall and Kylie become so successful at such a young age. Season 1. Chris isn't sure of Scott. In the first season of Keeping Up with the Kardashians, fans fell in love with a famous family who resided in Calabasas, California. After gaining fame the old-fashioned way, Kim, Chris, and the family were set for stardom. Unfortunately, the mom and matriarch of the family was still a little skeptical of her daughter's boyfriends, with one in particular throwing up Chris's radar for red flags. In season 1, Chris was vocal about her distrust of Scott, Courtney's then-boyfriend. At the time, the older sisters were running a clothing shop called Dash, and when Scott stopped by, he pulled a big new boyfriend no-no, prompting some negative emotions from Chris.
I have serious doubts about Scott.
As we say goodbye to the Kardashians in reality TV form, we are sure we haven't seen the last of this family.
Oh, that sucks.
Like chatting online and exchanging emails about their pregnancies and just really connecting
okay. Yes,
over
their...